Hi guys, welcome to Front Pro. Hope you all are doing great. In this video session, we are going to understand how we should construct an Angular application from scratch. For example, if you have to design an application for bank, then you may have entities like transaction, audit, clients. A user may or may not have access for all entities, right? So dumping all the models to a user who has a specific access is not a good idea. We know in Angular, a module is nothing but a combination of other modules, components, services, directories, pipes, etc. Now you may ask, hey, some components, services or modules are common across the application. So how should we manage them so they can be reutilized? How should design considering different aspects of an application like performance, scalability, maintainability, etc. Okay, we have few conditions to fulfill here, like sharing, scaling, performance, and securing an application. In this diagram, you can see we have app module, core module, audit, transaction, client, and shared module. They together build our application, right? Now, you will ask me, hey, one user may not use audit module or transaction module. Right, you are correct. In this case, we have to think in a little different way. See, here we have app module, which is nothing but our bootstrap module, or you can say main module, from where the application starts rendering on the browser. Next, core module, which is a required module for all the users. It may have core services, core components like header, footer, and sidebar. Audit, transaction, and client modules are the feature modules, which should be delivered to users when required. Shared module, it will consist of all components, services, pipes, or third-party modules which can be used by feature modules. All right, so far we are good. Now, how we can deliver more feature modules when required? So the answer is lazy loaded modules. If you don't know what is a lazy loaded module, please consider watching my video on this topic. You can find a link in the description section as well. It is really a must know for all Angular folks. Now let's jump into the VS Code to see all these into action. Okay, so this is a sample application where we have our app folder here. Inside that we have modules. Module has been further splitted into core, featured, and shared. Right. If you look into the core module, we have three components: footer, header, and sidebar. Here you will see that we have already declared these components into this module, as well as we are exporting them, right? So that our app module can use them. Here you can see, and this is being used on our app component, right? Okay, now if we dig down into admin, audit, and transaction module, which are actually our featured module, right? So it has a specific structure. Here we'll see that we have audit module.ts, which has few components, and it has a model and services. The components, like, we can have activity and a user. So this model is all about, you know, auditing user actions, what he is doing, like when he or she has logged in, logged on, and what activity he has performed. So all things can be, you know, logged, maybe services, right? So that we need to do here. And if you see further, if you open the activity component, we have further model and services folder here, which has a service. The same we have models, right? And these are being used in our components here, right? Same way we have user. In user we have a model something like that, login time, user ID, activity name, and logout time, right? So this can be populated and sent across REST APIs to get saved into the database, right? So that is a different part altogether. Now, so basically what happens, we have feature models, admin, audit, and transaction, right? And we may have a shared modules. So shared module, something like Angular material module, where, you know, we can use this Angular material in multiple places, and this could be part of any feature module like admin, audit or transaction. So it depends like where we are going to use it. This may not be part of our app components where we are not using any Angular material model, right? So it depends. So shared model is something which can be used across the application. The way it has been structured is, let me reiterate, is that we have app, then we have modules, and here we have core featured and shared. Every component has their own model and services, right? And they are part of a particular module. And based on this on-demand strategy, we are actually loading them dynamically. So you can see here in the routing, we have a lazy loading stuff. If you are not sure what is lazy loading, I have already mentioned that you can find the links into the description. All right. So I'll just show you in a few moments that how the lazy loaded modules are being loaded into the browser, right? They also actually generates different chunks. For example, if I open this dist folder, which is actually has been generated after running ng build with prod command prod file like this. So here we have four chunks here, one for is ES6, another for ES5. And this is actually for differential loading. So you can find my another video on differential loading. For example, if you want to support only modern browsers, right? So you may, you know, reduce your build. So it's a good video, you can watch it. So let's run it. It will take a while. All right, let's jump into the browser. Okay, so here we can see that we have routing, and if I take you into the network tab, so you will realize that the moment we load this application, it actually loads some style scripts and all polyfills styles are being loaded. And if I clear it down and click on audit, you will observe the new chunk has been downloaded. Same with the transaction here, you can see, right? So this is an example of lazy loading module. The another thing we need to, you know, take care about the header, because this is a static text, right? So basically this should not be part of our change detection, right? So what I did, if I take you into the header components again, here you will see that I have actually detached this from the change detection mechanism. And if you want to really understand in depth, I think you can again considering my watching another video on change detection. I will just provide the links for these two into the description section. So I hope you will have now good idea that how you should design your application from scratch and what the best practices you should go for, so that your performance, your structure is more scalable, maintainable. On security, I would be coming up with more videos, so where we can implement interceptor, where we will provide the bearer token, right? So that we can definitely understand in a better way, but that will be in next video. So till that time, stay tuned. Bye bye.